On July 18th, 1980, at about 12:30 in the afternoon, a sheriff's patrol deputy responded to a call of a dead body found in the parking lot of Westlake High School, their upper lot, in a dirt area. The murdered woman was found at the foot of the hillside in the rear parking lot, and it was determined that she was sexually assaulted, she was stabbed and strangled to death at a location other than that location of that school parking lot. She was dumped there. Well, 35 years later, this murdered woman is still unidentified. Why she's identified is this killer left behind a silent witness. And in 2012, science got to the point that DNA was gathered from her clothing and under her fingernails that centered on Mr. Chost. So I can't overstate the amount of work done by the scientists, because just because you get it and there's a way to get it doesn't mean it's easy to locate and identify DNA. It's a lot of hard work, and we have some of the most committed scientists in the state. Well, as a result of this, detectives, which this case was already in the cold case agenda, it was already being reviewed because we don't let anything go on the death of a human being. This link obviously gave a big kickstart to this investigation. It wasn't long before we found that that DNA also linked to a Jane Doe murder out of the Kern County area. Investigators used every bulletin, Jane Doe bulletin board, that they could to try to identify these women. And I'll tell you right now that these women have both previously given birth. Somewhere there was a child in 1980 where their mother didn't come home. This monster found his victims everywhere from people walking to their car at shopping malls to college campuses. We believe that Chost traveled throughout several counties during his 4 months of freedom in 1980. And I'm going to talk a little about that 4 months of freedom and what preceded it. Investigators believe these women that were kidnapped and murdered could have occurred in either Tulare, Kern, Ventura, or Los Angeles counties. You see, Mr. Chost, I almost don't want to call him Mr., because this guy's a true monster. He just served time for an incident in 1977 where he kidnapped a woman at knife point, drove her to a secluded area just south of our border, the Calabasas Woodland Hills area, and basically left her for dead. Well, he got convicted of that because she could testify. He was released after that 1977 case in 1980. In August of 1980, because that was in June, he attempted to rob and kidnap a woman at knife point in a parking lot at the College of the Sequoias in Visalia. That woman got robbed, but got away and got out of the car. She survived. A week later, after that attack, he went back to the College of Sequoias and raped another woman at knife point. He was arrested for both those crimes and was convicted. But I'm telling you right now, he's eligible for parole in 2017. We have reason to believe, detectives do, that there may be additional victims of Chost's crimes. We're looking to speak with anyone who knew of or had contact with Wilson Chost between June 15, 1980 and September 15, 1980. And we're obviously, the mainstay is to try to identify who these women are, because there's someone's sister, possibly someone's wife, and there's got to be people out there that knew them. And we want to bring closure to that family, and so that they understand what happened to their mom or their sister or their daughter when she didn't come home that day. Those two murders, they were discovered within 3 days of each other. This case frames an ultimate importance of working cold cases in every jurisdiction. And if it wasn't for the investigators, the scientists, and the district attorneys that dedicate themselves to these cold cases, it would mean that this guy could have been paroled in 2017 be on our streets and affect someone else's wife, daughter, or sister. And there is no doubt in my mind that murders would occur again. We are going to be open to questions. The investigators are here if you have any. And at this time, I'd like to open it to any questions you might have.
My name is Joe Evans. I'm with the Ventura County Sheriff's Office. And the murders were done in similar fashion with a similar weapon. We submitted in 2011, and CODIS hit in 2012. Very fast. Just getting the DNA is not enough. You have to prove that he was the killer as well. And all of that takes time. And we had to do it thoroughly so that when we did make our move to arrest him and the district attorney made the move to try him, that we had everything finished properly. We won't talk about our interviews with him, but I will tell you that we have no information that he knew any of his victims prior to victimizing them. I won't speak to the death penalty issue. That's a district attorney decision that's made further down the road. Mr. Chuest was arrested for 3 counts of murder this morning, and the district attorney is filing all 3 charges. We can just tell you that there is evidence that both of them had had a childbirth prior to death, and they were both to be, we believe, to be 20 and 30 years old. So doing the math, we would expect their children to be anywhere between late 30s to 40s, late 40s, currently, today. And we would also expect, we would hope that they have brothers and sisters as well. We just don't know where these people have moved to. If they were from these areas originally, who knows where they moved to now? That's why the big reach out.
There's a lot of social media about, has anybody seen my mom? I would go home in the evening and I'd sit there in front of my computer and just study those websites, looking at photographs, trying to match these women to no avail. And I'm really hoping that with this, we can get out nationwide and see if we can't find families. It's just been really tedious. We've called tattoo shops, clear up into Seattle. We've checked Indian tribes because one of these women is believed to be American Indian. We have just reached out to all levels and to no avail so far.
We've the missing person database, California DOJ, the national database. We've been in all of these. Kern County, before we got their case, had exhausted unbelievable lengths to find out who their victim was. They sent officers to Washington because of the tattoo, to Seattle. They really carried the torch on finding that on their victim. And then we had to pick ours up in 2012 when the DNA hit.